Okay, so I'm with Sergey Choban and Gökhan Amcaoğlu at WAF in Berlin, November 2017. And Gökhan Amcaoğlu here is showing Sergey's new book,
yes,
Sergey.
Yes.
And the book is called, hold on, let me get this in German.
German
Architecture as Balance Act. Yes. Or in English, Architecture as a Balancing Act.
Yes.
In English, will be in the next year.
Yeah, it will be beginning of next year. Right?
So the key fact here is 3070. So
what is the number?
You've worked for many years looking at the morphologies and images of architecture in cities. This has been sort of, and you've kind of looked a little bit more past, looking at neoclassical period, the Renaissance period. Now you're trying to apply that to the kind of 21st century world. Can you kind of go over some of these ideas and what you feel is the relevance of this kind of architecture is?
Well, the idea is, I draw a lot, as you know.
Yes.
And there are my drawing, what is the point? I research with my drawings, what is the city scenery is.
Yes.
How the city begins to be an ensemble. And I noticed that in the way of iconic buildings in 20th century, we made as architects a lot, and we know the best of us who makes really wonderful iconic buildings. But these iconic buildings are not in the big number in the cities. It's maybe by 30%. Mm-hmm. But 70% of our cities are very normal buildings, very normal.
How do you define a normal building?
A normal building is someone what one commercial commissioner makes just for rent, like an apartment building, like office building, what is staying along the street and building like surrounding for some iconics. And if you go on the street, you see streets long here in Berlin, a lot of these buildings, and you see very clear the buildings are built before, let's say, 1910, and they're built after, let's say, 1950. Mm-hmm. And if you speak about over 1950, they're detailless, they're not so good design in the texture.
So this is the 70?
That is 70%. And they're beginning to be older very, very fast. Mm-hmm. And that's a big problem, because with this growing older very fast, we lose the old layer of contemporary architecture of this time. Because nowadays, if you go through the town of 19th century, you don't see only cathedrals or universities or city halls. You see also normal buildings of the time. And you are wondering about this building in Paris, in Rome, in Petersburg, in Vienna, in Istanbul, very nice. And nowadays, what we get nowadays from the layers of the town beyond of these iconics? That's the question. And this 70%, we have to, this book is about how to bring the 70% to higher quality, not to have to demolish it in very, very short time.
But if we bring that 70% to higher quality, wouldn't they also turn iconic?
No.
What's the strategy?
That is a strategy to, they cannot be iconic, because they are staying in the structure, in the very close structure of city. Mm-hmm. They have maybe at least one facade they can facing with to the street. And for this facade, we need to use some textures, some materials, some details to make the profiling, the structure of this facade more fine. To bring this background architecture on the level that could be very good ring for diamond, for gemstone, what is iconic building.
Today we have a lot in cities, this layer of advertisements on these buildings,
right,
and storefronts.
Right.
This seems to be kind of almost taking over this.
Yes, and we have to be very careful about that. That's why, for example, in Berlin, we have already many years, have to bring concept for advertising together with building permission. So we have to explain in which level your advertising would have which size or which type. Mm-hmm. And I think we have to be, of course, very careful about advertising in upper floors. We have to understand that this noise in the town, this noise of colors, should have some level and should have some stop border.
Is this issue something that you're also approaching in your own architecture? And you, what kind of strategies have you implemented to deal with it?
Absolutely. That is also my own strategy.
For example, you use a lot of stone details,
yes,
and decoration.
In my speech and also in the book, I speak about that I'm using in the surrounding architecture, in the 70%, a lot of stone, modern structures, but maybe better, deeper, detailed surface. Mm-hmm. And by iconic buildings, you can be, of course, more flat, more slick, but work with a sculpture, work with a figure.
the back, Louis Sullivan was a very famous architect, an American architect, who's dealing with these facades.
Yeah, absolutely.
In some senses, you're kind of continuing that tradition of taking the box.
Frank Lloyd Wright, for example, Frank Lloyd Wright has spoken, and his teacher Sullivan, they have spoken a lot about modernity of architecture. But if you see very clear the buildings of them, you see how big attention they have given, presented to the details. And these details are the surfacing, what is touchable, what is much more interesting by coming to the building narrow. And we have to speak about that.
Is it possible to do this level of detail with not so big budgets? What kind of strategies can we do this with for these normal buildings? What do you suggest?
Absolutely, absolutely. If you understand, all buildings of the surrounding of 19th and beginning of 20th century, they are built not for big budgets. I am very sure if we create these questions also to industry, so industry will answer with very, very good answers, with very good products. Even by my speech, there were a lot of production firms. They say that we have already some elements could be used very good for this kind of the language. As it could be used more detailed, could be used more fine, with more fine structure. And I think it is very important to ask the industry. And industry will pass through this way and will bring ideas more passful for this way if they are asked. If you don't ask, they don't bring.
Right, okay. So architects have to press and have a dialogue.
Have to push a dialogue, and then they get answer. If you don't push a dialogue, if you don't care about 70%, but only caring about 30, and do the way that 30% begins to be all 100, so we have either noisy towns or we have very, very much too modest 70% architecture, what would be demolished in a very short time. That's the point.
And as a last question, Sergei Choban architecture here in Berlin and in Russia, it's now almost 20 years, 25 years?
Yeah, 20 years. I'm
20 years. How do you feel? What do you feel is the direction for your architecture practice? Are you still going to be staying in this Eastern European geography? What do you feel is that?
I'm feeling that that it's interesting for me to build for the textures of European towns. And so far for me to build in such a towns as Moscow, Petersburg, Berlin, Dresden, Leipzig, Frankfurt is very, very big issue. And so I love to do that.
It's a kind of almost a regional yet global approach you've been taking.
It is not very global. It is like a building of texture for big, big, nice towns.
Okay. Thank you very much. That was Sergei Choban at WAF 2017. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm going to get back to you. I have some interesting